Okay, Ethan. So, true freshman. First things first, you're from Edinburgh.
I'm from Edinburgh, yeah.
Hold on. What's the actual mailing address?
The mailing address?
Yeah.
As in...
You Cambridge Springs. No, you're not Cambridge Springs.
I'm Waterford.
You're Waterford. Which Waterford normally goes to LaBeouf. Right?
Yeah, but I was right on the line.
You're right on the line, so McCain. You went to McLean.
So I went to Gerald McLean.
All right, so let's just talk about that. How did these rider guys sneak into Edinburgh, past Tim Flynn, right under his nose, and recruit you to rider? How'd they do that?
They were at King of the Mountain is when they first saw me. I took second at King of the Mountain, and they started talking to me after that. And, I mean, I liked what they were saying. And all along, I kind of knew that I didn't really know if I wanted to go to Edinburgh just to kind of get out of town and stuff. Didn't want to really go to school 10 minutes from where I live. So, and then they started talking to me, and I liked what they were saying. And Nick and Hangie, I mean, they're great guys. So they kind of swayed me to going to Ryder. So
it's working out pretty well for you so far. You're having a good true freshman year. You know, a lot of guys like the red shirt that first year. What's it like not redshirting and right in the starting lineup for you?
I mean, it's had its rocky parts. You know, you kind of got to learn as you go because you don't have that year to like get used to college wrestling. But I mean, Nick, Hangie, Kilgore, they're doing a great job of getting me ready. I've been getting better as the year goes on.
Does so. Dustin beat you up a little bit?
Nah, usually I beat Dustin pretty good.
But that's a great workout partner for you to have. Was he on the potential staff when you committed, or did that happen after you committed?
That was one of the big things. I mean, they said we're like 99% got Kilgore coming in, and I was, obviously it's a national champion at 197. You want to be a national champion. What better way to do it than train with a national champion? So that was another big thing that helped me go there.
So you're in like this weird transitional time of Ryder wrestling history. I don't know if you know this, but you know, Coach Taylor's, he's not there anymore. He's one of the winningest coaches in the history of the NCAA, right?
Yeah.
That guy's gone. Hangie takes over. Hangie's only ever known Gary Taylor as the head coach of Ryder, if you realize that. And he was an All-American for him.
Yeah.
And, you know, he's been there forever. You know, he's been there 25-plus years, right, as an athlete and coach now. What's it like being in that transitional period from Gary Taylor to John Hangie?
Honestly, you can't even tell. I mean, Hangie's just, he stepped right in, and he's a great head coach. It seems like he's been doing it for 20 years. I can't tell a difference, you know?
Do you guys think, you know, I mean, you grew up probably going to Edinburgh matches at Macomb.
Right?
Right? So that's weird, man. You're going back Sunday.
Yeah.
You're going back Sunday, and, you know, I don't know if they got Paddock wrestling 97, but it's going to be a dogfight, whoever you got. What's that going to be like, strapping up the wrong color and not the plaid? You know, because you're plaid through and through, you know, born and raised, right? What's it going to be like strapping up a different singlet in Macomb?
It's going to be fun. I mean, we got a great opportunity, too. They got that big, long EWL win streak. We can come in, and, I mean, I think we got the team to do it. So it's going to be fun going into Edinburgh, making some noise.
Are you going to hang out at home at all? Do you get are you guys going there tomorrow? Will you stay at home Saturday night?
Well, actually, my family won't even be in town Saturday because my little brother has a tournament over in Clearfield. So they'll be back Sunday. But
they'll be back for the match then?
Yeah.
Okay. Maybe you can like have your spare key and like sneak into your own room and take a nap. I don't know.
Take a little nap in the bed. I mean, 10 minutes away. Why not?
It's going to be, but that's weird. Think about that. You know, you're probably born and raised hearing bagpipes before they run out in the dark, right? And then they wrestle under the light. It's going to be different. Enemy territory now.
Enemy now.
All right. How many lairds are there?
There's four lairds.
Boys.
All boys.
Oh, man. Your mom must be a saint, dude.
Hey. I don't know, man.
She must be rough and tumble.
Yeah.
All right, you got to grab Coach Badley on. Coach Hangie, you got anything else for him?
Nope. Go Bronx.
Hey, thanks for the time. Good luck on Sunday against Edinburgh.
Thank you.